Jaguars and Titans in an AFC South showdown Thursday, 8 p.m. Eastern time right here on NFL Network, Fox, and streaming on Prime Video. And you better believe the Texans will be keeping their eye on that matchup. With the win over the Colts on Sunday, the Texans can clinch a playoff berth as long as the Titans lose or tie the Jaguars on Thursday night. Winners of 9 in a row, Deshaun Watson is on fire right now. What has the tape shown you, Sean, about his improvement within this season?
Yeah, we call that a t-shirt and a hat game.
Yes, it is.
They're definitely on a heater. Deshaun Watson looks like a totally different quarterback inside the pocket from a guy that played against the Colts in Week 4. Let me show you what I'm talking about. All right, this was from that loss in Week 4. 7 sacks in the game. Right, here's what happened. All right, pressure, getting a blitzer off the edge here who's picked up. And Deshaun Watson just doesn't trust the pocket. And look, he's coming off the ACL injury. You see the pocket right there. Plenty of room right there, plenty of cushion. He had 3 receivers to choose from right there. But he kind of runs into the pressure right there. He didn't trust it. He didn't sit in there and wait for somebody to get open. Now, I mentioned the ACL. I think the game was a little bit fast for him in Week 4. Here he is again. 3-man rush. All right, there's a nice pocket. There's no pressure. There's nobody around him. He's got a couple of underneath receivers right here, and he's got this tight end right here that's about to break through the coverage. Could have been a big play,
Griff.
But he just doesn't trust the pocket. Kind of gets a little antsy there, runs out of the pocket. Now, this was last week. This is the growth. This is the progression. Look at him in the pocket here. A blitzer coming up right up the middle of the pocket here. He sits in there. Eyes are downfield. He's not seeing the rush. He's not feeling the pressure. And look at this throw. Does a great job of the slant right there. The linebacker thought it interception. But great relationship, and it's all because he's showing poise in the pocket. He's trusting the protection. I see a totally different quarterback in Deshaun Watson. It's the reason why they've won 9 straight games.
Yeah.
He's only thrown 2 interceptions in the last 6. So he's been in fuego, and I love the confidence and the poise that he's showing. He's trusting the big fellas up front.
Improvement for sure since that Week 4 game, and improvement is the name of the game as we get to the Built Ford Tough Offensive Line of the Week. Right, Sean?
Yeah, speaking of trusting big boys up front, how about the Birds? The Philadelphia Eagles finally made it to the top with this list. Peters, Seumalo, Kelce, Brooks, and Johnson, they got it done. 130 yards rushing on the ground. Not 1 sack, not 1 quarterback hit. How about the right guard, Brandon Brooks? Not 1 sack this entire season. My man Jason Kelce did a great job in the screens and the draw game. Now look ahead to this week, Rhett. Great matchups going on in the trenches. The Eagles versus the Cowboys. That will feature Lane Johnson, the right tackle, versus DeMarcus Lawrence, the defensive end. It's going to be a great battle. Keep this in mind. DeMarcus Lawrence, 8 games against the Eagles in his career. Not 1 sack.
For more information on the week's best offensive line, you can go to NFL.com/Ford. Now, let's continue a look ahead here at this big-time NFC East matchup, Cowboys and Eagles. Coach, the Cowboys front 7, 3rd most quarterback hits in football during their 4-game win streak. What's impressed you most about this group?
Yeah, stunning what they were able to do against the New Orleans Saints, keeping them under 200 yards. And the way they're doing it is they're playing great, fit up, organized defense. They're playing Rod Marinelli's defense to a T. Here you're going to see Crawford down inside the gap. So they're all focused on that. What do? They bring Gregory slamming down from the end. Drew Brees has to slip to the outside. But now Crawford has looped to the outside to cover him to force the bad throw. Now this is a great one. Again, you're going to see the pressure on the inside. Watch what happens. He jumps inside this guard and center block. This is great, but it leaves the B gap exposed. Don't worry about it. Van Der Esch is there. He's going to fill in and cover him after the disruption of the initial jump. And then this is what it's all about. This is just playing physical defense on the inside. These two inside defensive tackles stone the double team. You see Smith and Van Der Esch come in and fill the gaps to build that picket fence I'm always talking about. And you see Lawrence just crashing down the end. This is 4th and 2 on the goal line. So you can see here on the standings, 9 and 7 may win this division. So the key becomes who wins the 9 and who lost the 7 and who was it 2.
Yeah, you're really coming down to it here. If you're the Eagles, you cannot afford to lose this game against the Cowboys, especially if you want to win this division. That's going to do it for us here in this Week 14 edition of Play.